हेलो। सो माय टॉक इज बेसिकली स्केच बेस्ड इमेज ड्रिवन एंड आई एम फ्रॉम ट्रिपल आईटी हैदराबाद। आई एम अ सेकंड ईयर स्टूडेंट। सो बेसिकली व्हाट इज स्केच बेस्ड इमेज ड्रिवन? इट्स लाइक यू हैव टू एंटर समथिंग एंड यू हैव टू गेट इमेजेस इन रिटर्न। सो देयर आर जनरली थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ इमेज ड्रिवन एल्गोरिथम्स। वन इज टेक्स्ट बेस्ड इमेज ड्रिवन व्हिच वाज लाइक डन अ लॉन्ग टाइम अगो बाय गूगल एंड इट जनरली सर्चेस द मेटाडेटा स्पेस। The problem with text is that it's very old and it doesn't even look at the images. So Google had a new system which was example-based search. What it did is basically given a image, you can give a similar images. So our thing is, what can you do with these kind of methods? Firstly, suppose I want to search any of these objects. One is a text query, not so good. So and what is the problem with the example-based method? The problem with the example based method is a chicken and egg problem. We want to query to get an example image, but the problem is we need an example image to query. So what do we do? Many researchers pointed out that okay, use sketches. So what are the standard approaches that they follow for using sketches? So what you do is that you have a sketch. For every image, what you do is you take the edges, because what they think is that the sketches are the representation of edges of an image. And just have a database query through some algorithms and get the answer. So what we wanted to do is we want to change this paradigm, and we said that okay, there is some problems in these approaches. What are the problems so that we can fix it? First problem is, you know, there's match shapes. We don't know what we're looking for. Like this, what I want to query was an airplane, but what I get is just similar shaped things, which might be fishes, which might be bats, etc. And the second thing is, the edges of an image are not quite what we sketch for. Like suppose when I sketch for a human, I draw a stick figure, whereas a normal human would not stand like this for the retrieval. So what we did is that it poses as a cross-model problem. That okay, we train a system with both images and sketches. So what we have is that we build features, say n-dimensional features for images and m-dimensional features for sketches. How do we generate these features? That's a different story. We use big convolutional neural networks for the images. When we get the features, what our problem is that we have to correlate these. Say, when I search for an airplane, what I want is I want airplanes written. I don't want similar shapes and all. So what we do is we teach the computer that okay, cars are together, bags and bags are together, birds and birds are together, and balls are together. So the question arises, how do we teach them? So our method is we maximize the correlation between similar classes. That's a mathematical aspect of it. How do we do it? Is it's a, we use a method called as cluster CCA. So basically what it does, it has a weight matrix. It's a joint dimensionality reduction problem in which there are two weight matrices, W and WS. We just maximize it. How do you maximize it? It has literature on it. I guess you can just see the papers. It is by Rasiya et al. They'll learn how to learn the correspondence. I just keep it for the time being. So what we use a correspondence class, cluster CCA and not formal CCA. What cluster CCA does is, it has class-wise correspondence. So what we want to do is we have no data except the class labels. So we want to correlate all the similar class labels, like cars with cars, any car with any car, but cars with cars. So that is how we learn it. And this is our pipeline for doing it. What we have to do is we extract features from the databases, and then we generate the projection matrix in the training part, and testing, we just retrieve the closest features in the space. So we use some data sets, and these are the results that we get. So now I would like to point to the differences in the results. Like say, so suppose I draw a bathtub. So T-Rain has like large range of sketches. So what we get is we get different kinds of bathtubs. Like here the bathtub is in the corner. Here it's a like close-up version of bathtub. Here is the circular bathtub where I search for rectangular. So we get all sorts of shapes into account, and what we want is the semanticness, that whatever we get should be a bathtub. And obviously it's ranked by the shape also afterwards. Like, we get rectangular bathtubs first, then followed by circular bathtubs, and then there's a bathtub in the corner. And similar for airplanes. Like, we get airplanes in different orientations. One is left, one is right, one is diagonal shaped. We also get some false queries, which is, that's a camel in the desert, but looks like an airplane. That's all we can tell. And obviously, we get around 200% improvements on state of the art. And yeah, so to summarize my talk, I would like to say that what we have is, using computers and deep neural nets, we can see what images and what sketches are. See, we can go from, this is a car, this is a sketch of a car. What we want to do in our aim is, now we want to relate these categories. So, okay, computer sees something. How can we relate these things with each other? And like, how to relate sketches domain with image domain and make computer understand relations and not only see objects. And this will be it. Any questions? Because I guess I did it in very overview. At this point, what we're tackling is, given a sketch, identify the roughest, well, like, it can be anything in the world. Identify, like, suppose if it's a car or a scooter or a bicycle or a toy or, and then you, once you have on a database of cars, you can do a fine-grained version of it. So generally, in any problem, what we do is, we have, like, one dataset which does for the large scale, like, in images, it's the ImageNet. It detect classes among everything. And then we can do fine-grained versions like bird dataset, like which bird it is. Any other questions? So one application that we are thinking of, we are building a system for generating movies out of, like, just you draw things. What I'll do is, you draw a sketch of a car. It'll give an image of a car, and then you will draw a sketch of a mountain. And it'll just give you an image of a mountain, then you can just extract those by segmentations by the MS Coco kind of things. And then what you do is, you know, this is a car, this is a mountain, you can place them, and then then you can apply physics as done in the MIT work. So you can actually generate a movie just by drawing. This is what we are doing now. And yeah, this does not correlate by shape. This correlates by the meaning of it. So we are trying to incorporate semantics. So, like, we want cars and not this shape. So suppose there are cars, trucks, and cycles, and suppose it's in orientation this and this. First, it will like general traditional approaches will retrieve cars sideways, trucks sideways, scooter sideways, and then others. Ours will do is, it'll get all cars first, first sideways, and then other orientations, and then it will go to trucks. So.
Our next speaker is a bit